Welcome to NewsClick. Today I'm marching along with thousands of other women who have congregated in the heart of Delhi to give a very strong message to the Modi government that women on the International Women's Day are actually promising to vote out the Modi government. The reason being that the failure of the Modi government's policies towards women, and more importantly, the very deeply ingrained idea of Brahmanical patriarchy that guides the policies and the actions of the government.
The day primarily for two things. One, to remind ourselves that women have fought for their rights and of course have gained many a right, and to resolve to continue the struggle for democracy, equality, women's rights and women's emancipation.
नमस्ते सबको, मेरा नाम आयशा है और मैं NNSW से आई हूँ, नेशनल नेटवर्क ऑफ सेक्स वर्कर्स से, जो कि हम नेशनल लेवल में, लोकल लेवल, रीजनल लेवल और इंटरनेशनल लेवल में हम काम करते हैं सेक्स वर्कर्स के राइट्स के लिए, जो कि उसका मानव अधिकार है, उसके लिए हम काम करते हैं. इंडिया में हम 8 राज्यों में काम कर रहे हैं सेक्स वर्कर्स के अधिकार के लिए, जो कि वॉलंटेरी सेक्स वर्कर्स जो अपने सहमति कॉन्सेंट से आते हैं और चॉइस करके आते हैं सेक्स वर्क में अपनी इच्छा से, उनके अधिकार को लिए काम करते हैं. क्योंकि बहुत सारे डिस्क्रिमिनेशन स्टिग्मा हमारे खिलाफ, बहुत सारी विरोधी होते हैं, हमें बहुत सारा का भेदभाव भी हमको सहना पड़ता है, लेकिन इस आंदोलन में हम आए हुए हैं एक साथ जुड़ के, हम आगे बढ़ने के लिए और वुमेन्स डे सेलिब्रेट करने के लिए इन सॉलिडेरिटी. धन्यवाद.
दो सो मेनी लॉज आर देयर फॉर विमेन एंड चिल्ड्रेन. द मेन प्रॉब्लम इज दैट इट इज नॉट इम्प्लीमेंटेड प्रॉपरली. इफ द इम्प्लीमेंटेशन इज डन प्रॉपरली, वी कैन रिड्यूस दिस काइंड ऑफ वायलेंस अगेंस्ट विमेन. Now the children are not safe, women are not safe. We feel afraid to travel in Delhi, being this capital, and all around in different states the level is different, and their womanhood should be celebrated every day, not only today. So that's my message, and it has to start from the family, not from the society, because the society is actually it is deep rooted. So it has to, the change of mindset has to start from the family itself. Thank you.
So there is, on the International Day of Women and the celebration that marks the resistance, multiple women from different quarters of life, be it domestic workers, sanitation workers, workers who are involved in sex work as well, have come forward to celebrate this day of resistance together. They're also very clearly stating that there is a message being given out to the Modi government that they will vote them out eventually. King, along with Rubina, who is carrying her child on her back. These are the women who are living in shelter homes in Jama Masjid in New Delhi in a very small cluster. These are women who have no employment and no place to go, with pathetic conditions in the shelter homes as well. They don't have social security, they don't have any employment, and they are trying to make do with the small contracts that they get to work in people's houses for a few days. So many women like her are marching today to demand their very right to social security and dignified life.
Today we are particularly here, I'm also here with the National Network of Sex Workers. Aisha is going to speak with me on the stage. Both of us are going to put our demand forward about how the sex and sexuality also needs to be really looked into. We totally understand that we are with everybody and we want everybody with us. It's not just, and furthermore, I'd like to add that our society also has a lot of stigma against single women, unmarried women or divorced women. And so when we talk about women, there are multiple other identities who are facing a lot of other different types of stigmatization. And that also need to be brought into fore. That also need to be discussed. The silence needs to be broken. And we all need to come together for their rights.
Well, on this Women's Day, where we extend our greetings to women all over the world and India, we remember the origins of Women's Day, which was really based in the struggle of working class women for a strong resistance to the kind of exploitation that they faced. And I think today, in 2019, when Indian women are facing such a huge conservative backlash because of the environment created by the BJP RSS's dominant ideology, which sees women in a very stereotypical way, and particularly working women. They look down on working women because they feel that working women are not fulfilling their real role as mothers, as sisters, as subordinate to men, and they are breaking tradition by going out to work and ruining the ideal Hindu family. So I think it is very essential that we assert the reality of women's autonomy, of women's freedom, of women's struggles, of women's sacrifices, which have brought so many women out of the darkness of the kind of Manuvaadi societies that the BJP wants us to live in. So today we pledge, resist these right-wing forces, fight back the assault on our very being by the Hindutva forces, and make sure in the coming elections that they're voted out of power.